Hi everyone, in this lecture we're going to implement bidirectional streaming RPC with Java. We will implement the same Red Laptop API that we have built with Golang in the previous lecture. It allows client to rate multiple laptops with a score and receive back the average rated score for each of them. We will also learn how to write unit tests for this new streaming RPC. Okay, let's start. As we have already defined the Red Laptop RPC in the last Golang lecture, I will just go to the PC Book Golang project and copy the contents of the laptopservice.proto file. Here we have the new Red Laptop request. It contains two fields, the laptop ID of type string and a score of type double. Then we have the Red Laptop response, which has three fields, the laptop ID, the number of times that laptop is rated, and the average rated scores. The Red Laptop RPC is a bidirectional streaming RPC, so it takes a stream of requests and returns a stream of responses. Pretty straightforward, right? Now let's click this build button to generate Java code from this protobuf definition. Okay, the build is successful. Now let's start with the new rating class. This class will contain the rating matrix of a given laptop. So we have an integer count to store the number of times the laptop is rated, and a double sum to store the sum of all rated scores. I will generate a constructor with these two fields, and also generate two getter functions for them. Alright. Now we write one more function to add two rating objects together. This function will be useful later to update the laptop rating in the store. It's very simple. We just return a new rating object, where both count and sum are computed by adding the corresponding fields of the two input objects together. Now let's define the new rating store interface. It will have only one function, add, that has two input parameters, the laptop ID and the score, and it returns the updated rating of the laptop. Let's create an in-memory rating store to implement this interface. Similar to the in-memory laptop store, we will have a concurrent map to store the rating data, where the key is a laptop ID, and the value is its rating. We initialize the map inside this constructor. Now in the add function, we have to update the laptop rating atomically, because there might be many requests to rate the same laptop at the same time. To do that, we use a merge function of the concurrent map. Basically, this function takes a laptop ID key, a rating value to be used if the key is not associated with any value before, which should be rating 1 score in our case, and a remapping function to update the value of an existing key. In our case, we want to add 1 to the rating count and score to the rating sum. So we just use the rating add function here. This merge function is amazing and very convenient, but I want to make sure that it works correctly. So let's write a unit test where we concurrently call ratingStore.add from multiple threads. First, we create a new in-memory rating store. Then we create a list of callable tasks, which will return a rating. We generate a random laptop ID. And let's say all tasks will call ratingStore.add with the same score of 5. I'm gonna add 10 tasks to the list. So let's use a for loop here. And inside we call task.add with a lambda that has no input argument, and it will return ratingstore.add with the laptop ID and score. We use a set integer here to keep track of what rated cal value has been recorded by the store after each call. Then we call executor.newWorkStealingPool to create a new worker pool, then call invoke all and pass in the task list, turn it into a stream, and iterate through the element using for each. Each element will be a future object, so we call future.get to get the output rating of each call. If we catch an exception here, just throw an illegal state exception. Else, we expect that the sum of rated score should be equal to the number of rated times multiplied by the score. And we record that this count has appeared in one of the function calls. What we expect to see is there should be exactly n different rated counts, and the value of them should be from 1 to n, or 10 in this case. Okay, let's run this test. It passed, so the ratingstore.add function is working perfectly for concurrent calls. Now let's implement the server. First, we need to add a new rating store to the laptop service class and update this constructor with a new field. Because of this change, we need to update the constructors of the laptop server class as well. And in the main function, we have to create a new in-memory rating store object and pass it in the constructor to create the server. Alright, let's go back to the laptop service to implement the Rate Laptop API. Similar to the upload image API that we wrote in the last lecture, we have to override the new Rate Laptop function. It has a response observer as input, and must return an implementation of the stream observer Rate Laptop request interface. Now in the onNext function, we get the laptop ID and the score from the request. Write a log here saying that we have received a Rate Laptop request. Then we find the laptop by ID from the store. If it is not found, we call responseObserver.onError with status code not found. And return immediately. Else we call ratingstore.add to add a new rated score of the laptop to the rating and get back the updated rating. Then we build a new response with the input laptop ID, rated cal taken from the rating object, and every score computed by dividing the rated sum to count. We call responseObserver.onNext to send this response to the client. In the onError function, we simply write a warning log. And finally, in the completed function, we just call responseObserver.onCompleted. Okay, let's try it. The laptop server has started. Now we will connect the Golang client that we wrote in the previous lecture to this Java server. Three laptops are created. Enter Y to rate them. As you can see, the laptops are rated with scores of 5, 1, and 4. Perfect. Let's enter Y again to rate them one more time. Now they are rated with new scores of 10, 3, and 7. And the rating has been updated with rated count of 2 and average scores of 7.5, 2, and 5.5, which are all correct. Awesome. So the Java server is working very well. Let's implement the Java client. I will define a rate laptop function that has two input parameters, an array of laptop IDs and an array of scores. Similar to the upload image client, we need a countdown latch to wait for the response stream to finish. Then we call async stop.withDeadline after 5 seconds. .rateLaptop and pass in the implementation of the stream observer rateLaptop response interface. In the onNext function, we only write a log saying that we have received a response with this laptop ID, this rated count, and this average score. In the onError function, we write a severe log with this error message and call finishLatch.countdown. In the onCompleted function, we write an info log and also call finishLatch.countdown. Now we need to start sending a stream of requests. Let's iterate through the list of the laptop IDs. Build a new request with the laptop ID and score. And call requestObserver.onNext to send the request to the server. Then write an info log saying the request is sent. Let's surround this for loop with try-cat. If an exception is caught, we write a severe log. Call requestObserver.onError and return. Finally, we call requestObserver.onCompleted to tell the server that we won't send any more requests to the stream. And we call finishLatch.await to wait for the response stream. Okay, the rateLaptop function is ready. Now before calling this function, let's refactor the code a bit. I will write a separate function to test the Search Laptop API. Copy and paste the code in the main function here. Let's also add a function to test the Create Laptop API. And a function to test the Upload Image API as well. Alright, now let's implement a new function to test the rateLaptop API. And call it from the main function. Let's say we want to rate 3 laptops multiple times. So here I declare an array to store the laptop IDs. Use a for loop to generate random laptops. Set the ID to the array and call createLaptop API to create it on the server. After that, we need a scanner to get input from standard input. Use a while loop here and inside, ask if the user wants to do another round of rating or not. scan the next line. If the answer is no, we break the loop. Else, we will generate a new array of scores. I will add a new function to the generator class to simply return the random laptop score, which is an integer between 1 and 10. Then call that function from here. Finally, we call clients.readLaptop with the laptop IDs and the scores array. And we're done. Let's run the server. Then run the client. Three laptops are created, and the wire to read them. Looks good. The requests are sent and the responses are received. Let's read them one more time. Here we can see the new scores are sent and the returned average scores are updated. Excellent. Now before we finish, I will show you how to test the bidirectional streaming RPC. You can base on that to write tests for the client streaming RPC. They are very similar. First, we need to add a new rating store to this class. Initialize it inside the setup function. Pass it into the constructor to create a new laptop server. Then here we add a new test for the Red Laptop API. Let's create a new generator. Generate a new random laptop and save it to the laptop store. To be simple, I would just read one single laptop multiple times. Here we have to create a new stub from the channel. Remember that it's an async stub, not the blocking stub as in the unary RPC. Then we need to define a new class that implements the stream observer read laptop response interface. In this class, we will keep track of three things. The list of responses, an error if it occurs, and a boolean to tell whether it is completed normally or not. Since this class is only used for unit tests, I will make all of these fields public. We also need to initialize the responses list inside the constructor. Then in the onNext function, we add the received response to the list. In the onError function, we save the throwable T to the error field. And in the onCompleted function, we just set the completed field to true. Alright, let's go back to our test. We create a new read laptop response stream observer and call stub.readLaptop function with that response observer. Now we will send three requests with scores of 8, 7.5, and 10. Then the expected average scores after each request will be 8, 7.75, and 8.5. We use a for loop to send the request sequentially. Inside the loop, we build a new request with the same laptop ID and the score from the scores array. And call requestObserver.onNext to send it to the server. At the end, we must call requestObserver.onCompleted. Then we assert that the error is null. The response stream observer is completed. The size of the responses should be equal to the number of requests. And finally, when we run through the responses list, the laptop ID should match the input laptop ID. The rated count should be equal to the response index plus 1. And the average score should be equal to the expected value. Okay, let's run this unit test. Cool, it passed. Let's run the whole laptop server test. All tests passed. And that wraps up all lectures about implementing four types of gRPC. I hope you find them interesting and useful. Thanks for watching and see you later.